John. I'm fine.
That's Lorianne.
Yes.
How about it's that?
It's certainly good to see you.
I'm her agent.
You.
You're her agent, yeah. And I'm glad you're here, but how did he get you to do this?
Well, of course, Harold is my agent now, and
he said to
be here at 8 dressed, if you can call this dressed.
Yeah.
Be here at 8 dressed and ready to go, so here I am. What do you think?
Well, I think it's great, but how did he get you to do this? I mean, I don't understand.
Well, it beats what he had me doing.
Which was?
Last week, this guy had me washing cars at the Zircon station.
There you go.
And he made me do it like this.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, that's easy.
You're talking about tips.
I'll bet she got tips.
Yeah. She did.
Listen, we're glad you're here, and I appreciate it.
Thank
but
you.
Usually what we need two people to do what we do.
Oh, we have two people today.
Oh, you do?
We have two people.
You have two? All right.
Come on out.
Charlie Chase.
That's Charlie. I made these two people what they are today.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
They're both from my stable of stars.
And obviously somebody left the stable door open, didn't they?
No, it's not open, Charlie.
Charlie, trust me, you look stunning.
Thank you.
Thanks for noticing, yeah.
What is in the bucket?
Well, actually, what I have here are tips that I made from washing cars down at the Zircon station. Here's a penny. This is your 10%.
You only got a dime? I'm going to put some shorter pants on you. Although they couldn't look much sillier than those.
No,
but I'll tell you this. You give new meaning to the phrase funny business.
And you give new meaning to the phrase super agent, too, I might add.
Yes. Well, I'll tell you what, you all have done a great job here, but I'll tell you one more thing you have to do now.
Okay.
Y'all got to go over and flip the cards.
Oh,
flip
the
cards. Hold you. I'll hold
okay.
Go over here.
I'll hold you, buddy.
Y'all go and turn the cards. There you go.
That's one of the jobs.
Okay.
These people are great.
They're
I'm telling you, they are doing a good job for me.
They're going to do. I'm sure they are.
They really are. We're going to fill
that
bucket
up. All right, y'all fixed. You ready?
We're ready.
You guys?
We're ready.
All right. Okay. All right. It's a great show tonight. We have Glen Campbell.
Good job.
Yeah. Alison Krauss in Union Station. Wes Harrison, and our own Rex Allen Jr., Janie Fricke, the Bill Walker Orchestra, the sweet voice of Sherry Page, and of course our good friends, Crook and Chase, Lorianne and Charlie, and we'll all be back.
Brought to you by Fruit of the Loom Casual Wear, comfortable clothes to wear when it's your time.
It's your time, spend it in Fruit of the Loom Casual Wear. It's your time,
spend it
in Fruit of the Loom Casual Wear.
It's your time,
Fruit of the Loom,
spend it
casual.
You know, I can still remember the very first candy given to me by my grandfather. It was Werther's Original, and I was 4. I had a little trouble opening that shiny golden wrapper, but then, well, I'll never forget that first taste. Sweet and creamy and just plain good. But there was something else, too. I remember feeling I must be somebody very special when my grandpa gave me his wonderful butter candy. So, now I'm the grandfather. And what else would I give my little grandson but my Werther's Original? He's somebody special, too.
Honeymoon in Vegas, a comedy about one bride.
I want to be married.
Two grooms.
Bessie! Stand on me!
And 34 flying Elvises.
We're the flying Elvises, Utah chapter.
Rated PG-13. Starts Friday, August 28th at a theater near you.
Tangy Heinz 57 sauce. We've yet to see a nugget that hasn't dug it. Heinz 57 sauce. It's like ketchup with a kick. Tangy Heinz 57 sauce. We've yet to see a nugget that hasn't dug it. Heinz 57 sauce. It's like ketchup with a kick.
It's common knowledge that there are some things in this old world that you're just not supposed to tamper with. One of those sacred things over the years has been bluegrass music. It's always been a man's game, but that is history. Today, we have a young lady who can stand up and be counted with the best of them. Make welcome Alison Krauss and Union Station. Gentlemen, Alison Krauss of Union Station. How about it?
Yeah.
You know, it's hard to look at someone and tell what they do for a living.
Like me, what do you think I do for a living?
Almost nothing.
Yeah, but I do it as cheap as anybody can.
Well, that's true. This gentleman you're about to meet makes noises for a living. He does trains and gunshots and duck calls.
I can do a duck call.
You can?
Here, duck. Here, duck.
That's how you call a dog.
I got a dog named Duck.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is Mr. Sound Effects, Wes Harrison.
Oh, thank you, Large. I suppose you wonder why I'm dressed this way, right? Kmart, blue light special. No, I'm a duck hunter. Hunt ducks. And I tell this story with all these sound effects done vocally. Sounds like horses. Here comes a horse. Isn't that interesting? Oh. Same horse, this time doing a trot. same horse crossing the wooden bridge at a gallop. Thank you. Same horse, cowboys on his back with a Colt 45 shooting. Shot the horse. Oh, it was a bad shot. Remember the Colt 45, very famous gun. Every cowboy carried one of these things. They only loaded it one time. It was good for the entire movie. That's right, all the cheap cowboys load up and shoot, shoot, shoot. Never load the fool thing. Oh, there's a beer can. I like that. I got it. Gotta rush along. I said I was a duck hunter, hunt ducks. One duck. You want to hear that again? Do it again. That was a pig. Pigs don't fly. And I tell this story. Every duck hunter's got to have a dog, so he calls his dog. It's not a dog. That's a poodle. Get out of here. Poodles are not dogs. They're fixtures made of latex. I got to have a dog. Come on, dog. Ooh, that's a big dog. Dog is going to meet our duck hunter out at the pier where the boat is. So he runs out on the pier, jumps into the boat. Missed the boat. Gets into the boat, pulls the rope. Pulls it again. You son of... That's the name of it. Takes a hammer out, works on the engine. Oh, tuning the engine. He pulls that rope hard. The engine is running across the lake to the duck blind. Wet crossing. In the duck blind, ready to hunt ducks, turns on his radar. Turns on his radio navigation. Turns on a sonar. For the Russian submarines. Here comes the first duck. Ready for duck dinner. Somebody opens up with a machine gun. Somebody else opens up with a cannon. Full-scale war over one duck. We all missed it. That ends our story of the duck gun. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Wes Harrison.
Wes Harrison.
If you want to meet the man who put super in superstar, you're in the right place when we come back.
Last night, Russ Beeler, owner of Lake Edna KFC, opened Hammer's eyes to new popcorn chicken. Delicious, crispy, bite-sized morsels. A whole new way to enjoy the Colonel's chicken.
Come on, Hammer.
The problem was, no one could get him to go on until the last piece was gone.
That's pop.
New KFC popcorn chicken. Treat yourself for $1.99, the band just $5.99 in Lake Edna or your neck of the woods.